people versus dog people. It's the eternal debate. Luckily, we have pet behaviour expert Amy Shojai breaking down four covert ways pets have your number. Number one, guilty or not guilty?
A lot of people think that dogs show guilt, but in reality, what's happening is they're trying to stop the loud, angry voices. Maybe you come through the door every day expecting that Fido has done something wrong, and they learn every time you come through the door, Mom's gonna yell at me.
So while dogs may look like they feel guilty, what they're trying to do is trick you.
They give you that face. That puppy dog face that is just, it is designed to say, Mom, cool your jets, don't yell at me.
Cats, on the other hand, wear their guilt on their fur.
They'll hide under the bed, they will learn to associate your hands or whatever with bad experiences, and then they turn around, they start frantically grooming themselves.
This frantic grooming is designed to lower their body temperature so they can calm themselves down. So, where there's guilt, there's hairballs. Next secret, dogs and cats know you in different ways. Cats use a communal scent to identify their social circle.
Cats really need to recognize by scent. They calm themselves with scent. Rubbing against you, that's a sign of affection and basically saying, I own you, you're part of my territory.
Meanwhile, it's not scent, but sight and sound that helps Fido recognize you.
Dogs are quite a bit more visual, especially from long distances. If you come in, they're not used to that silhouette and you're wearing a hat, it just doesn't look like Dad. You know, and they aren't gonna recognize you until you call out their name.
Oh, hey, it's me, buddy, it's me, it's me, it's me. Good boy.
Secret number three, cracking the code. Did you know cats don't chat with each other by meowing?
Cats have learned that people are very verbal. And as a result of that, cats have almost created a cat language specifically aimed at people. They will go to the cabinet, they'll paw the cabinet, and then they'll look at you and meow. And you gotta give in.
Dogs, meanwhile, are masters of the stare down and wear down, mooning at you with those big dewy eyes and methodically directing you to their treats.
And they will look from you to the cabinet, to you to the cabinet.
Fourth secret, showing the love. When a cat gives you the cold shoulder, it isn't a sign that you've been shunned. In fact, it's the exact opposite.
That's not a human snub. That's a cat declaration of, I trust you so much, I don't have to watch you.
For dogs, it's a cold nose, warm heart.
The way dogs typically show deference and how much they love and trust you is they'll raise a paw. So a paw is a sign that, hey, you're the boss, I love you.
So the big question remains, who loves us more, dogs or cats?
Cats are not dogs. Dogs are not cats. Come on.
So, in the end, maybe all that matters is that we love our pets and they love us. On the top of the list.